Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome to my channel. In this video, I will be showing you how to build a chatbot using Llama and Groq API. I will be working with Next.js, TypeScript and Tailwind CSS, but you can follow along if you are working with React.js, the process would be same. The link to the source code is in the description. So without any delay, let's get started. First, we are going to initialize a fresh Next.js project. If you don't know how to do this, just follow along with the video. You can name your app however you like. I will be naming it Llama Chat. After that, I will show you my preferred settings for the Next.js project, but feel free to customize them as needed. Next, navigate to the newly created project directory. Now visit the official Groq website, go to the developer section and click on Start Building. From the left hand menu, click on Documentation. Scroll down a bit to find the JavaScript documentation. We also need to install the Groq npm package, so go ahead and install it. If you check the documentation, you will notice they recommend storing the API key in .env.local file. This is a good practice. It ensures that we don't accidentally expose our API key. Now open the project in your preferred code editor. You will see the versions of the dependencies used in this project. In the root directory, create a file called .env.local and add your API key there. To get an API key, go to the API key section of the Groq website and create a new one. Next, open the page.tsx file located inside the app directory. This is our main file and you will see the default code. To run the project, open the terminal and execute the command npm run dev. Then open the localhost port in your browser and you should see the default code rendered. Now we need to handle the chatbot's API. To do this, create a folder named API inside the app directory. This tells Next.js that we have some API related code there. Inside the API folder, create another folder called chat. And within that, make a file called raw.ts. The raw.ts file defines an API endpoint for a chat application using Next.js. Here, two important modules are being imported. NextResponse. This module helps create response that can be sent back to the client. The Groq SDK is imported to help communicate with Groq service, which allow us to use the Llama chatbot model. Here we are creating a Groq object using the Groq class. We provide an API key which is stored in an environment variable. This line defines an async function called post, which means it will handle HTTP post request. When a user sends a message to the chat, this function gets called. Await request.json converts the request into a JSON object. We extract the message property from it, which is the text message sent by the user. Next, we check if the message is missing. If it is, the function returns a response with an error message saying message content is required and the status code is set to 400, meaning bad request. Here, we are using Groq object to send the user's message to the Llama model. Groq.chat.completions.create is a function that sends a request to the Llama model to generate a response. The message array contains an object where role is set to user, content is the actual message text sent by the user. The model specified is Llama 3 8p8192, which is the name of the Llama AI model being used. Next, we extract the response generated by the Llama model. It checks if there is a response message. If a response is found, it is stored in the response message. If there is no response, it defaults to no response from Llama. Response message means the return response will have a key call response with the generated text as its value. This catch block handles any error that might occur during the request processing. If something goes wrong, it logs the error in the console and returns a JSON response with an error message. An error occurred while processing your request. The status code 500 indicates a server error. Now we will make some changes in the global.css file. It's a minor update where I have modified some default CSS properties and added my own. If you are good at CSS, you can create your own classes as well. You can pause the video here to write the code, as it's a small change and I don't want to waste your time. At last, we will write the code for the page.tsx file. The code in the page.tsx file creates a simple chat interface where user can send message and receive replies from the Llama chatbot. UseClient is used to specify that this code will be run in the browser, not on the server. Several React hooks are imported: useState for managing state, useEffect for running side effects, formEvent for handling form submissions, useRef for creating references to DOM elements. A message type is defined, representing each chat message with three properties. Chat page is the main component for the chat interface. UseState is used to manage different states. The first state is messages, an array for chat message, initially it's empty. The second state is input, the text the user types in the input field, start as an empty string. The third state is loading, a boolean that indicates if app is waiting for bot's response, initially sets to false. Message and ref is a reference to the bottom of the chat messages. It will help in automatically scrolling to the last message. Scroll to bottom is a function that smoothly scrolls to the bottom of the chat whenever it is called. UseEffect runs the scroll to bottom function every time the messages array changes. This ensures that the most recent message is always visible. HandleSubmit is an asynchronous function that handles form submission. e.preventDefault prevents the default behavior of form submission, which is to reload the page. Next, input.trim ensures that the input is not empty for just spaces before proceeding. A new message object is created representing the user's message. The message is added to the list of messages using setMessages, which updates the chat display. SetInput clears the input field after message is sent. SetLoadingTrue sets the loading state to true to indicate that the app is waiting for the bot's response. The fetch function sends a post request to the chat API with the user's message. The request is sent in the JSON format with a content type of application/JSON. The message content is included in the request body. The response from the server is awaited and then converted to JSON. If the API request is successful, the bot's response is added as a new message to the chat. If the request fails, an error message is displayed to the user. Both the bot's response and the error message are added to the message's state. If an error occurs while trying to fetch the response from the server, a console error is logged and a generic error message is displayed in the chat. Finally, whether successful or not, setLoadingFalse is called to stop showing the loading state. The chat interface starts with a container that has a flex layout and takes up the full screen height. The header displays a title, Chat with Llama, at the top of the page. A chat message are displayed in a scrollable container. Each message is mapped to a chat bubble, which is styled differently depending on whether the message is from bot or the user. When the app is in loading state, a simple animated loading indicator is shown to indicate that a response is being generated. The entire UI code is AI generated. If you have been following the video up to this point, simply copy your code and paste it into ChatGPT or Sonnet 3.5, then ask the AI to generate the UI for the chat app. Don't waste your time here. However, if you are not satisfied with the results, you can continue following the video. It's a simple UI built with Tailwind CSS, so feel free to modify it as needed. And that's it. Now simply save your code and check your browser and see your chatbot in action. You can chat with the Llama AI here. If you go to the Groq documentation and check the model section, you will find many open source large language models. You can use any one of them you like. Just copy the model name, paste it into your code, and you are good to go. It's as simple as that. And that's a wrap. I hope now you have a good understanding of how to build a chatbot using Llama. If you found this video helpful, then hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye.